24 profiling the next big thing. We're off to New School.
New School, the show that brings you the faces of the future. UK hip-hop has yet to make a mark on the charts like its Big Book's US counterpart. In an Eminem and Wu-Tang dominated playing field, it's hard for UK acts to get recognition. This week we catch up with Mark B and Blade, the London-based duo on a mission to change all this and put UK hip-hop firmly on the musical map. Blade, who's an Armenian-born Iranian, is one of Europe's most renowned underground rappers. He teamed up with Mark B, a hot new producer hailing from Kingston, Surrey that is, to produce an album, The Unknown, that's been well received in the hip-hop community. We catch up with them as they prepare for their biggest headline gig yet.
UK rap artists are certainly, they're shining far more than ever, selling more records, the scene's definitely getting bigger, and I think Blade, who's a real, you know, cat from the old days, from the old school, it's right that he comes forward and, you know, has success. He's worked long and hard at this, man, and that's a tremendous thing, man. I know Mark is a very serious producer, you know, he's got a lot of hot beats, and he's certainly be putting it on for the UK as well, so for them to stay with it and to have the success is tremendous, man, well deserved.
The longer waited. I'm sort of like a doctor, about to operate. Fast cooperate, waiting for source to set the date.
At the technical guy's inside set up for tonight's gig, we join Blade and onstage rhyming partner Deficis outside.
Well, tonight we're hoping to see the likes of DJ 279, maybe even Tim Westwood there. Hype man very extraordinaire, Deficis, on stage with us. We're going to make it an event that people are never going to forget. As you can see, Mark B and Blade posters everywhere. And we're now stepping into the gig to do the sound check. Here we are at the venue.
Ali G, I love you.
Our lighting man, Mr. Jeff. What's up? Killer Keller.
Hey, you alright, dude?
Plus one.
Oh, wait.
We got Benny G from the Mixologist.
What are you saying, mate?
This is my manager, Jason Knight. Tour manager, Jazz. We go upstairs and go and introduce you to Mark. Behind you, we have Mark B, who's doing the runner. What's up, Mark? And this is the venue, the Mean Fiddler. It looks nice and gritty. It's just the kind of place I like, and it's the kind of place you can imagine everyone's going to come there for the music, for the event that's happening, and everyone's going to totally go bananas. I'm sure they will. If they don't, we'll make them.
I got into hip-hop music around 83.
I got full steam into hip-hop in 1982 with Wild Style video.
It's just like, you know, the breakdance era when it first hit the country.
Malcolm McLaren with Buffalo Girls and everything.
Herbie Hancock, Rocket, Tyron Bronson, Smurf.
A few years after that, you had the Ultramagnetic MCs and everything. And by that time, I was hooked anyway.
It was all about fun. And I feel sometimes the fun's missing out of hip-hop, especially now. Like, you go to a lot of shows and it's like 50 MCs at the front, you know, just moody faced. And, you know, we're trying to, like, break down some barriers so that doesn't really happen for us, you know what I'm saying? So it's working well.
Good news, it's sold out. The event is sold out, totally.
Essentially, both of them really feel hip-hop and what they want to do. They're very much kind of sort of on a mission to try and help British hip-hop. Mark, obviously, the production is excellent. As a producer, you know, he's got a vision of what he wants to do. Blade as a showman, he's got sort of a star quality to him. And he's a little bit sort of erratic and unpredictable, but people like him. And I think, you know, Mark's more reserved character doesn't quite, you know, demand attention in the way that Blade does.
I first met Blade literally 3 or 4 years after we'd been talking to him on the phone. We became great friends. This is around between 90 to 94 or something like that. Basically, yeah, we're great friends and we still are. First and foremost, forget music, we're just good mates, you know what I'm saying?
Being on tour with Mark, how can I explain that? It's like any relationship. You have your really good times and then you have your times where you don't agree with things, in all honesty. Overall, we're still having fun, and we'll continue to keep having fun, and we'll keep enjoying everything, and that's the way it is for now. As I'm walking up these stairs, I'm trying to think to myself how this compares to all the other gigs that we've done. Not many places we go, we have our own dressing rooms, we have to share with everybody else, and look, Progress, Mark B and Blade, dressing room. And I hear loads of voices and I can't get in. Look at this, a mirror and a tap. I don't believe it. That's Dave. He's actually the guy that signed Mark B and Blade.
Mark and Blade are a funny pairing. Mark definitely brings a very serious musical side to it. Blade, on the other hand, was a complete lunatic when I first met him and is still mad, but in a good way. He's really mellowed with time and he's just really easy to work with. It's a pleasure to be around. I think they complement each other because Mark would rather be in the studio and Blade's happy to be the front man. He really loves dealing with people and meeting people and kind of putting a smile on people's faces, and he's good at that.
I confused them and made them think that the venom was now fully extracted. I'm fully active, but now that I'm here, you've been subtracted.
The record label behind the duo is Wordplay, the hip-hop division of French label Source, home to the likes of Air and Turin Breaks. The team at Wordplay are working hard for the boys in order to spread the word about the album, The Unknown.
I signed my record deal with Wordplay Source in 1999, and we've got a good team behind us. They all know what they're doing.
They're putting money behind us, and they're going out there making sure people are trying to get it played on radio. We're getting press. We are getting out there much more than we would if we were to be on a little independent label or doing it off our own backs. The Unknown is basically about the struggles of like artists and whatever, making people realize that, you know, it doesn't matter how talented you are, how much knowledge you have, how much whatever, it's not about, you know, what you know. It's basically about who you know. You make one contact in the industry that's in an influential position and all the doors begin to open. And that's basically what happened to me and Mark.
We've got some Mark B and Blade t-shirts, and I'm going to nick one.
It's non-stop work for the guys. Press interest is building up, and there's just time to slot in some interviews and publicity shots before tonight's big Central London gig.
I take my brain out of my skull each night and clean it nice and neatly. Hold it gently, be careful not to drop it. Relax it, give it a break from the daily nonsense. Close my eyes and think positive thoughts. When I wake up, I place it back inside of the skull.
This is a very, very key gig. If we do a terrible show, it could be all over for them. It's happened before with other artists that I've personally worked with. This particular show, if it goes off well, we've got people down ahead of programming for Radio 1. We've got people from Top of the Pops, CD UK, a whole another level.
The bus finally came about an hour late. The driver looked at my pass but couldn't see the date. He said, hey, the fare will get off so I could drive on. That's when I knew the whole day was gonna go wrong. I made it to work in one piece. The manager called me in and began waving his fists and babbling. I didn't hear a word cause my mind was on finishing this album on schedule. I'm smiling cause of the gap between his teeth. He's losing his temper cause I'm smiling while he's nagging me.
Backstage, all the support crew are crammed into the boys' dressing room prepping for a night to remember. But how is Mark B feeling about tonight's big gig?
I feel, you know, very confident with what we've done. You know, it's like when we done the first show, which was Fresh down in Birmingham down last September, I was nervous, I'll be honest with you. You know, it's like I've never been on stage doing my own music, you know what I'm saying? But this is really the kind of next step up the ladder with Blade, you know what I'm saying? Blade is so well respected, he's been out there, he's done, you know, hundreds and hundreds of shows. And I know that he can rock a crowd regardless of whether I'm there or not, you know what I'm saying? So me just to be with him at first, I was very nervous of it. But now, you know, I'm going to get up there tonight and love it. Every show I'm up there, you know, I don't care if there's 200 people in there, or hopefully tonight we have 500 to 1,000 people in there sold out. So yeah, like I say, you know, I'm very confident we'll be doing, just going to get up and have a good laugh and a good show, you know?
Mark B and Blade will be getting strong support tonight from DJ Plus One, the current holder of the World Best Acts Turntable Championships. Join us after the break to discover whether the gig flew off or took a dive, and to visit the set of Mark B and Blade's first promo shoot. Welcome back to New School, the show that tracks the talent of tomorrow. We join UK hip-hop team Mark B and Blade on their mission to break into the big time. Later we'll be going on their first big video shoot with hot new directors Barnaby and Scott. There's a remix single out with a gritty new sound, and the video will get the track out to a much wider audience. Promos are all very well for the gloss and the glamour, but to get full respect in the hip-hop community, you've got to be able to perform live, on stage. Tonight is Mark and Blade's biggest headlining gig to date. The venue is packed to capacity, and it's time for Mark's beats and Blade's lyrics to come together and rock the house.
Come on! Yeah. Come on! Are you party your ass off? We work our ass off to give you something to party to. Yeah. Take our hats off, the beast that Mark created. We're happy that you made it to witness a performance that you'll never forget. From the United Kingdom to auditoriums all around the world, people are spreading the word. Tell them we're coming, MC, veteran gunning, yeah. For profit and gain. My mission to entertain. Crowds of fell asleep waiting for something deep.
How can I describe the feeling of performing in front of an audience? I'd say it's one of the most incredible feelings in the world. It is literally, I think that's what I was born to do. Seriously. Was I born to entertain or to evaporate like I'm steam? Now scream. That's all it's about for me. Entertaining. Nothing else.
And all in due time, everything will be obvious. The story is greater than those who'll be victorious.
Working with Blade has been a very good experience for me. I've learned a lot of good things. A lot of people see him as a very serious guy. A lot of people see him as a joker. And that's being nice to him, because that's how he is, you know. The only place where it really does get on my nerves is when we get in the studio and I'm recording, and like he starts doing jokes when the choruses are coming in, and I've got to rewind, wipe it off. But the jokes do get a bit far stretched sometimes, and like I've heard the same joke like 50 times, but that's cool. It's Blade, you know. It's me, moody on the tour bus, pissed off. It's like, that's us, you know what I'm saying? Take it or leave it. I'm sorry.
Live performances of rarity, time for change, rearrange the plans.
Mark and myself are probably an odd couple, but there's so many people I could compare us to. We could be the Gallagher brothers, Liam and Noel, Laurel and Hardy. Unfortunately, I'm the fat one and he's the thin one, so opposites attract.
What did David, Mark B and Blade's label manager think when the title track from The Unknown played out?
The roar that went up, you could see everyone's kind of had mentally prepared themselves for it. When you saw everyone's faces, everyone was taken aback a bit, so that was great. And then, you know, just the crowd singing along to The Unknown, you know, because you don't really know how much people have heard the record until you go out on the road and you really see it. I mean, the guys tour all the time, but for me to see it, I hadn't really seen the reaction of crowds since the single had come out, and to see people all kind of singing along to the chorus was really quite fun.
You can say what you want to say, but remember it's rare that you begin to continue with airplay. We are the unknown.
Now you know the name. Unstoppable, clever, artistic. You're about to enter a higher level dimension. We're fantastic.
We are the unknown.
I can see them becoming very, very big live band. The feel-good factor, as a hip-hop band, that's their kind of unique selling point. There's a warmthness, it's kind of very much, look, come and be a part of this, rather than we're doing our thing and you're not there. So it's very much, you kind of say, right, let's have some fun, but listen, we are actually talking about something here. And I think they're getting success from that.
I don't want to stand up on stage and basically have people staring at us and going, problems, and then go home and think, oh, I'm depressed now.
I think I'll just shove a needle in my vein.
Do you know what I mean? That's not what we're about. We want to make sure that the only drug that we give people is what we're doing, music. We want you to go home and be on a high on what we've given you. And that's all we're about.
You know what I'm fucking saying?
Well, I've been rated as one of the greatest rappers on the planet.
I doubt it.
But Mark be rated as one of the greatest producers.
I doubt it.
It's not because we ain't good, it's because we're from London. That means we're stigmatized. We can't be original. To hell with that prehistoric thinker.
Because your shit's singing, it doesn't mean that
I'm not for
crowd loved it. Sold out, which is incredible for a British hip hop group, I think, especially, you know what I'm saying?
Investigating the scene, exposing all perpetrators. How dare you compare yourself to Jesus, claiming he came to all the disciples.
Step this into stage, when you see him, y'all made it.
We ain't here to play, we here to slay. You better pray, you can bring Robocop, Terminator, Superman. Step to the front, but bring your back on. Yo, you just to the side because you're blind. You're running out of time. I'm losing my mind, yo, it's a crime. Stand back and watch a professional rap arrive. Put the mic down, boys, the show is mine.
Basically, the state of hip-hop in the country at the moment is on the rise. There's a lot happening. There's a lot of talent out there that's not getting a fair shot. But it's going to take more than just one act for something major to happen.
British hip-hop groups on stage at the end. That was just a good thing to see, because you never really see that anymore, you know. It's like, it showed some sort of unity, everybody was hugging each other at the end and stuff, and that was cool.
London, thanks a lot!
After the successful gig, there's a chance to meet and greet the fans, and have yet another photo call. But at this point in their careers, there is no let-up. Next day, we jump aboard the Blademobile as he's whisked the exotic Isle of Dogs in London's East End for Mark B and Blade's first ever promo video shoot. And it seems that the publicity campaign is paying off.
Right here we have a magazine called Hip Hop Connection, and apparently there's a good review of ourselves. Hey, there's Mr. Westwood. We're just trying to track down where we are. Best producer, Mark B, number 3. Best single, number 3 as well. Oh my gosh. Right there, number 1, Best British Rap Act. It means more when you read these things and you know that they're voted by the public. It is a reader's poll. But at the same time, I think in the long run, it's only about the music. That's what it's about. It's not about the awards and stuff. It's just about making good music.
The animal of rhyme, extreme intelligence, building the stats. Go off, the understanding is you can't have it back. So
back to work. Oh,
the video's been shot from a track called You Don't See the Signs, which is actually the first track we put out a year ago now. But we wanted to remix it and come with something different, and Feeder had been talking on the radio about how they really like Mark B and Blade, and so we put them, Grant from Feeder, in the studio with Blade for the weekend and got a rock remix, which is great. I mean, I wouldn't say a year ago I would have thought I'd be doing rock mixes, but it's a, you know, it's a heavy track and there's a good vibe, and Blade loves the energy of it, which is the main thing. So it kind of brings out the best of Blade.
I think doing this track, you know, with this other musical genre, this rock edge to it, will, you know, basically bring more people in to check out their own record. And if they do that, that will mean a forward kind of progression for their album, which is a pure hip-hop record.
And blood will stay up, come with danger up. Should I never play tough, trying to play with you? For real, something to think, something to feel. I feel my skill killing the mic is drugs real. And yo, why you recognize the lesson I'm stressing? Roger P, Mafia and Blade, a progression, yeah. But stay up, come with danger up. Should I never play tough, trying to play with you? Great, stay up, come with danger up.
The video's being directed by Hotshot directors Barnaby and Scott, who have previously worked with the likes of Wookiee, Maxim and Moby.
Barnaby and Scott really have ideas. Each of their videos had a really clever idea. You know, they get on great with the guys, which matters as well. So
they've got like an artist perspective of what people want, you know what I mean? They've listened to the track, listened to the lyrics. It's going to work well, you know what I mean? We've been looking back at the shots and we're thinking it's going to do something really good here, and hopefully it's going to be groundbreaking, you know what I mean?
It starts off with a parody of the American video. Mark and Blade arrive at their first video set. They're over-the-top record company people, girls in bikinis. There's a big flash Lexus, and they go out and they start the shoot, and they're clearly uncomfortable in it. At the end of the first verse, they basically have enough, push the girls away, steal the camera, and run off into the local estate. And they basically shoot their own video. But it's them with the camera, so it's not as if there's a third person with them. They just take the camera, they throw it around the place, kind of try and bring the energy of the track to life.
Will Mark be rated as one of the greatest producers? It's not cause we ain't good, it's cause we're from London. That means we're stigmatized, we can't be original. To hell with that prehistoric thing. Just because your ship's sinking, it doesn't mean that ours is. I'm known for wearing Carhartt jeans, not ties and trousers. Your lifestyle is safe as houses, mine is unorthodox. All ecstasy, we never had no videos on the bar.
I've been watching you. You've been looking dead at your shows, and as it goes, you're the cause of enacting his pros, and one of these days you'll be exposed. Cause he knows you aside.
It's not a huge video, it's not Busta Rhymes or Janet Jackson, but it's a, you know, a decent sized budget. So I think it'll be one of those things that you look back on in a, you know, a few weeks once it's settled down and go, yeah, that was wicked, rather than at the moment I think everyone's just a bit, let's get through it because it's freezing out there.
I got the world in the palm of my hands, and as things stand, I intend to steal your fans. Form under your nose, whether your friends or foes. I've been watching you, you've been looking dead at your shows, and as it goes, you're the cons who've been acting as pros, and one of these days you'll be exposed. Cause he tells you the signs.
This track feels like a hit. I think things are set up properly for it this time. We've got a bit of time to, you know, get this video out to television. The press has been solid all the way through what we've been doing. It's fingers crossed, really. If we get this record and it does less than a 30 in the national charts, then I think we've really messed it up.
My mind, it's a crime. Stand back and watch a professional rapper rhyme. Put the mic down, boy, the show is mine.
The next step for us really is just seeing reactions to this record, you know, see what happens with it, and, you know, hopefully it'll mean more album sales. It's going to open a lot more doors for people like ourselves that are willing to be open-minded about doing things like, you know, the rock crossover thing. So we'll just see what happens, really, yeah.
Fast play the evidence, you lose control of the emotions. Couldn't hack it, could you think the world should rotate around what you do? But you're sadly mistaken. Here's a rude awakening, you ain't gonna win.
They're good enough musicians that they'll keep coming out with stuff. They'll be going for a long time still, you know. I can really see both of them in their own way, in their own areas, being really, really strong, you know, long-term artists. And that's the thing, it's not about one single. It's really about developing them as album artists. And they will. Blade's got so much music in him, the same with Mark. Mark's, you know, always in the studio making new beats, so I think there's a lot more to come from him.
You don't see the signs because you're blind. You're running out of time. I'm losing my mind. It's a crime. Stand back and watch a professional rapper rhyme. Put the mic down, boy, the show is mine.
I persevered with this because, in all honesty, I had this gut feeling that something was going to give way. Just because we had an opportunity doesn't mean you're going to get it. You're going to get it because you work hard and you went for it. Not because Mark B and Blade went in there and opened the doors. It doesn't work that way. You need to go in there and show people that you're prepared to do the time.
The crates ain't really good together, you know what I'm saying? It's like a good combination there. I think with Blade's lyrics and my beats, we've got one powerful force that cannot be stopped right now.
Stand back and watch a professional rapper rhyme. Put the mic down, boy, the show is mine.
Mind-bending stuff with Darren Brown on E4 tomorrow at 9. Back to tonight and a whole load of one-hit wonders. Tonight's top 10 is next.